Ball on the second day, Bruce Roberts. Mary Corstead's hit it straight over slips. I've got two runs in Tomahawk Creek straight on the attack. Two off the first ball. Bruce Roberts coming in to Tom Holt. Just props forward and plays it out to Keith Turner. Into the first over with two runs off the first ball and then a leg by. It's Rod Swain to take the new ball. The other end, bowling to Eric Horstead on two. Made it over to Rod Swain, his first of the morning. Bruce Roberts to Tom Holt. Allows it to pass through to the keeper. Maiden over. Got substitute fieldsman Philip Mycross substituting for Greg Hay. Jimmy Boyd in the backward square leg position. Robert Pike first slip. Anton Boyd the keeper. John Hall in the gully. It's Rod Swain coming in to bowl to Eric Horstead. Single to Eric, to spare leg. And to bowl to Tom Holt. Rod Swain coming in, but Tom Holt pulled away at the last moment. Turning, running in to bowl to Holt. Just drops it forward, fielded by the bowler. Captain John Hall in the gully. Just a single off the over. Tomahawk Creek, no wicket for four after four overs. Brian Boyd probably come on as a first change bowler. Bruce Roberts comes in to Eric Horsted, hooks it round. It's a misfield by Rod Swain. It's gone for four. First boundary at the Tomahawk Creek innings. Eric's looking full of business early in the innings. Let's moving into bowl to Horsted. Good length, right up in the block hole. Bowling to Horsted and he hooks it round again. I don't think Swain will get to this one either. It's another four. Umpire Malcolm Roberts. Busy this over, signalling two fours. So far, a couple of short balls and Horsted has had no trouble whatsoever to dispatch him to the boundary. He waits now for Roberts to come in. Just plays forward, that's the end of the over. Expensive over for Pombonite. Wayne the bowl to Holt. Turner in the covers, quite a nimble fieldsman, been known to throw the wickets down from side on a number of occasions. Another tremendous fieldsman for Pominique, Colin Beale. For nothing, as you see. Great example there of Beale's fielding prowess. Very lively. Swain to Holt. Straight back to the bowler and no run. Bowling change and Brian Boyd will be brought into the tack. Place of the man on the screen at the moment who conceded two boundaries off his last over. Appears to have a bit of a limp at the moment, Bruce Roberts. However, it's Brian Boyd being brought on. A few fielding adjustments. He'll be looking for a wicket shortly. Dead waiting for Boyd. Down the leg side. Horsted on 13, going for his shots. He waits now for Brian Boyd to come in. Bowls and Horsted plays it back to the bowler. For Boyd, he just plays it down in front. End of the over. Two runs and a leg by from the over. The Creek, no wicket for 15. to slip. Peel and most of Pombo Green. Poor Robert's unmoved. Boyd has struck. Tom Holt out without scoring. Clean bowl. They did have an opening partnership. 15. Just the boost Pumanique Green needed at this stage. New batsman Ray Farquharson, very experienced campaigner in the finals, very dogged batsman. Ray Farquharson faces his first ball from Brian Boyd. Ends up one outside the off stump. Wicket over to Brian Boyd. Suddenly Pumanique Green have got a bit of spring in this. Keith Turner showing his ability again. Very quick to seize upon the ball and return it to the keeper or the wicket. Swain to bowl to Horsted. Just plays it behind square to Jimmy Boyd. Swain moving in to bowl to Farquharson. Drops it down on the inside, no run. Take two runs. To Farquharson. Just plays it down to the gully. End of the over. Three runs off it. Swain to Horsted. Boyd in the ball to Farquharson. Just drops it down behind square and they run a single. He runs to horse. In the bowl to Eric Horsted. Into the over by Swain. Score is 1 for 27. Batsman out, Tom Holt. Bowl Brian Boyd for no score. Wicket fell at 15. Bruce Roberts had none for 10 off 3 overs. Rod Swain's got none for 4 off 8 overs. Brian Boyd a bowling change and John Hall being brought into the attack. Hold the bowl to Horsted. Fielded by Robert Pike. And by signalled by umpire Roberts. Last ball of Hall's first over coming up. Bowling to Farquharson. Into the over. He runs to Horsted. End of the over, three runs off it. Tomahawk Creek, 1 for 34. Paul to Horsted, turns around to find leg again. They run another single. Four runs to Horsted. It's seven off the over so far. Looks at round square and another single to Horsted. End off the over. Eight runs coming from it. Score 1 for 40. A bowling change with Robert Pike replacing Rod Swain after a fine spell, yielding only 7 runs from his 9 overs. Runs to Horsted through between slip and gully. Fielded by the claw, full of energy. End of Pike's first over. 3 runs off it. The score is 1 for 47. The Hall being replaced. The attack by Captain Ken O'Neill. Could be a key man. Taking a lot of wickets. Single to Horsted. End of O'Neill's first over, just a single off it. Single to Horsted. Parkinson hooks it round, square leg. That's a 50 for the creek. 1 for 50. Single to hold it. Possible run out chance there. Hooked round by Farquharson. Just the single. End of the over. Tomahawk Creek, 1 for 53. Ball, signal by umpire Matheson. End of the over. Out. Ray Farquharson, caught Keith Turner, bowled Robert Pike. Wicket over for Robert Pike, taking the wicket of Ray Farquharson. Caught Keith Turner for 13. The score being 2 for 53. Barry Corstead, 36 at the moment. Alan Menean about to face his first ball. Been a bogeyman for Pominique Green over the last year or two. Made a magnificent century in the grand final last year, facing Ken O'Neill. Man off the mark with a 2. Score 2 for 55. Keith Turner, man that took the vital catch to dismiss Ray Farquharson in Robert Pike's last over. Very keen on the move all the time. Snipped by Horsted through the slips for a single. Brings Manan up the striker's end to face Pike for the first time. Pike moving in the bowl to Manan. Taken on the pad, but clearly too high. Fielded by Whitecross. The sub, and they just ran an easy thing. An easy single to Manan, moves on to four. Harry Corstead on 37, plays for O'Neill. He hooks it round, there'll be two at least. Three runs to Harry Corstead. Magnificent catch. Green have taken the vital wicket of Alan Manan. Should be a real team lifter, a catch like that. Wicket over for Ken O'Neill, taking the valuable wicket of Alan Manan. He has the figures of 1 for 9 off 5 overs. Alan Manan out to court Jimmy Boyd for 4, score being 3 for 61. No ball signalled by umpire Matheson. Another one. Four runs to Horsted. Pull shot through square leg. Moves on to 44. End of the over with 4 runs. Plus the 2 no-balls. O'Neill to bowl to Lee Gordon. Well stopped there by Jimmy Boyd. Couldn't prevent the single. O'Neill to bowl to Horsted. Cuts it down into the gully. Just trot through for an easy single. The ball to Lee Gordon. Fight. End of the over with Tomahawk Creek 3 for 68. This field there by Brian Boyd has Harry Corse dead to take a single. Horsted. Pays it down. Rolling to Horsted. End of the over. Pike to Lee Gordon. Pays it back, fielded by the bowl. Lee Gordon tucks up and just plays it down along the pitch. Drop catch. Chance for Lee Gordon there off Ken O'Neill. End of the over. Drop catch off that over. Usually rely on Jimmy Boyd. However, it's the first chance they've missed today. To Lee Gordon. Fielded by umpire Matheson. Two runs to Lee Gordon. Ray Farquharson appears to have a weapon of some type there. He hopes no one feels the brunt before the end of the day. of O'Neill's over. The score on 76 for 3 wickets. Pike to bowl to Lee Gordon. Just plays it up to mid-off. Caught by substitute Fieldsman Wycross. Only a youngster. Being congratulated by the older players of Pominique Green. Lee Gordon leaves the scene. New batsman Russell Manan coming in with the score at 4 for 78. Corstead, the captain, being not out on 50. Pike to bowl to Horstead. Two boys. For Pike, it's 2 for 15 off 10 overs. First ball to Russell Manan. Moves in. Plays it into the vacant gully position, but can't take a run. O'Neill coming into bowl to Russell Manan. He's gone hard. It's Robert Pike to bowl to Russell Manan. Moving in to bowl to Manan. Goes for the cut shot but fails to connect. Wide signal by umpire Matheson. By Manan, 4 runs. End of the over. It's Ken O'Neill bowling Derek Horstead on 50. Gets it down to Brian Boyd in a gully. O'Neill moving in. Horstead cuts it back. Fine a first slip. And then Robert Pike with a long chase. They take 2 runs. Four runs to Horstead. Batting very well this morning. Down the edge, but safe to Pike. End of the over. Good score on 92 for 4 wickets. runs to Russell Manine. This pike following to Russell Manine. He has it to pass through to Cooper Anton Boyd. Take an easy two to Manine. End of the over from Pike. The score on 96, and yield the horse dead. Made a lot of shots down that area, hitting him straight into the ground. Kneel to Horsted. Stopped just inside by Beal. Two runs to Horsted. An easy two to Horsted from that shot. Backward a square leg. Brings 100 up for Tomahawk Creek. 4 for 100. He's pulled it round again. Got a 4 this time. The end of the over. Bowling change. Brian Boyd has replaced Robert Pike. Robert Pike, after a spell, had 2 for 23 with 12 overs. And Brian Boyd, who had the initial breakthrough for green, brought back into the attack before lunch. Keith Turner's just cut off a 4. Restricted the scoring to 2 runs to Russell Manine. They move along to 106. Boyd to Manine. Off the back foot, just plays down to mid off. The end of the over. Another bowling change, and it's Jimmy Boyd. Possibly only one over after this one before lunch. It's Horsted waiting for Jimmy Boyd. Little French cut. Backward a square and they take a single. Boyd just directing his fieldsman before bowling to Russell Manine. Brian Boyd bowling to Eric Horsted. Tabs at the point, no run. Brian Boyd bowling to Eric Horsted, who is on 65. Allows it to go through. Long chase for Robert Pike. The batsman just walked through for two runs. Takes the score on to 109 in the last over before lunch. Bearing in mind, last week Pomeneet were 1 for 103 at lunch, only to collapse straight after. It's Russell Mann waiting for Jimmy Boyd. Reaching time and kept just a little low. Jimmy Boyd has achieved the breakthrough just before lunch. Russell Mann, I think he might have got an edge, played it back onto the stumps. So at lunch on the second day, score is 5 for 109. End of the over, it's just the one ball after the lunch adjournment. After taking the wicket of Russell Mann with the second last ball of his over. Proper score at this stage at lunch was 5 for 114. After conferring with our chief statistician, we were just a little bit behind. 5 for 114. It's Brian Boyd to resume. Bowl to Eric Horsted, who is not out 65. Two runs to Eric. Moves on to 60. A wide signal by umpire Matheson. Score moves on to 107. Chance there by Bruce Roberts of Horsted. About the first chance he's given for the day, batted very well. Another drop chance. Green putting down two chances in that over could prove very costly. Jimmy Boyd the bowl to Jeffries. Jeffries off the mark with a single. Through to the keeper. Four Boyd, who had the two chances missed off him in his last over, into bowl to Jeffries. Off the back foot. Digs that one out of the block hole. Two runs to Jeffries, over slips. New Boyd bowling to Horsted. Fielded by young Philip Wycross. Sub fieldsman who took a great catch. And the Jimmy Boyd's over and he has one for six off four overs. Jeffries just playing Boyd back along the pitch. Into the over from Boyd. Maiden over. Single to Horsted, just a prod out to mid wicket, fielded by Keith Turner. Two runs to Jeffries, Jimmy Boyd into bowl to Jeffries. Phasing defensively down the wicket. End of the over. Score 125. Single to Horsted. Jeffries waiting for Boyd with him here. End of the over. It's Ken O'Neill coming into the attack now. having 1 for 9 of 5 overs. Catch there by Robert Pike. Green certainly letting their chance slip after lunch. 3 catches, Eric Horsted being dropped on each time. An appeal for LB. No response. Very disappointed captain there. Could have had Horsted out. Boyd to bowl to Jeffries. Taken down on it. Had Green with a number of chances last week. Only the 1 chance dropped before lunch, but 3 dropped since. Single to Horsted and the score moves along to 127 for 5. O'Neill to bowl to Jeffries. Keeping a little low there from Boyd. Eric Horsted on 72. Jeffries, just leans forward, doing it by the bowler, no run. The man coming in, close as O'Neill moves in. Jeffries just forward. Single. Come on. single to hold it. Into the over. Jeffrey's out, caught Colin Beale off Ken O'Neill. Score now 6 for 129. Jeffrey's out for 6. New batsman Dennis O'Dwyer. Face up to Ken O'Neill. For a stumping there. Last ball of O'Neill's over. No run, wicket off the over. Boyd struck at last. I've got Eric Horsted here. Ryan's bowled 4 maidens in a row, as well as taking the wicket of Eric Horsted. Very vital wicket indeed. Applause for Eric Horsted as he leaves the ground. Magnificent effort. Appeared, lacks a little bit after lunch, gave a few chances, very solid before. So do I, waits for Ken O'Neill, just plays it out to the gully. Dennis O'Dwyer, disappointed at that, went for the big hit, didn't quite get it. New batsman at the wicket, Larry Hillman, Dominique Green have got a real chance now. Tomahawk Creek have been a stumbling block for him for a number of years. However, cricket's a funny game and it's not over yet. Score on 8 for 129. It's Captain O'Neill to bowl to Bernie Casey. Oh, bit more enthusiasm in the green side now. Very dejected in the middle of the session. That's two runs to Kate. Boyd to bowl to Murray Hillman. Boyd to bowl to Hillman. Space forward. Another maiden over to Brian Boyd. Magnificent catch by Pike. Make amends for the one he dropped earlier. Great catch, reminiscent of the time he caught Max Cassell in the final. Last time Pominate won a premiership. Very vital catch. Bernie Casey out for two. Last man in, Alan Hillman, two Hillman brothers. Got a big task, got to add 50 runs for the last partnership. Both known to give 110% to their side. It's Ken O'Neill to bowl to Darkie Hillman. Hits it into his pads. No run. Tomahawk Creek retiring 50 runs to win. The last batsman at the wicket. Putting a little bit of pressure on. Hillman settles over the bat. O'Neill bowls a quicker ball. He's looking to hit him away, but just hasn't made contact yet. Dabs it into the gully. Plenty of pressure on now for both sides. Single to Alan Hillman. He's off the mark. Ken O'Neill coming in to Murray Hillman. May have got an edge. Obviously did get an edge. A little bit of byplay there between Hillman and Boyd. Quite a character, Darkie. It's Brian Boyd moving in to Murray Hillman. Plays it back on the offside. Bowls and Hillman pulls it out to mid-wicket. They take a single. Ryan Boyd running into bowl to Alan Hillman. Shapes to turn it round to leg. Throws it straight back along the pitch. Thank you. coming off the over. First run for 7 overs off Brian Boyd's bowling.
And he'll
bowl to Hillman. Going the big hit. Bruce Wright stops it.
Sends in a
fast return to the bowler. Couldn't prevent the single. Moving in to bowl to Hillman. Into the slip area. Keith Turner. He's bowling. That's it. Tom and Eat Green go into the finals. Been arch rivals for years before the amalgamation of the association. Sure, Pomonita would be very thrilled at beating him in the semi. Getting a little bit of a rev from the captain, realising that the job isn't over yet. The Tamar Creek captain there, he calls.
Dead.
Offering congratulations. Disappointed man after making 73. Seeing the side dismissed for 135. Thanks, Mel.
So straight to the bottom I go.